Hello and welcome to BJA Today. I'm BJ Arnett and I have a very special guest with me today. Today we're going to be talking to Patricia Taylor. Now let me tell you a little bit about this awesome woman. First of all, she's a GG. Okay, if you don't know what a GG is, you will have to get with us GGs. That's a grandmama, in case you didn't know. She's a wife. She is a fantastic businesswoman and even a better actress. But today we have her here because in all of those many hats, she is the one who is the co-president of Georgia Production Partnership. Thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me here.
This is an exciting time for Georgia.
It is.
The state is booming with lots of revenue for film and television. We are an explosive force to be reckoned with.
We are. We are third in the nation right now with production here in Georgia, and we're fifth in the world.
That's an amazing concept. Talk to us about what it's like to see this kind of growth from your many positions as an actress, mm-hmm. as a businesswoman, as a leader and crying out for keeping work in the Georgia community. What's it like for you to look back from years ago to now to see this boom?
It's amazing. I mean, if you look at all the productions that when we first started Georgia's Film Office, which was back in the 1970s, to when the Production Act was started in 2008, there were like 750 productions, television, radio, you name it, film productions that were shot in that whole time frame.
That's not very many.
Then you go to last year, mm-hmm. the fiscal year, there were 245 productions for
TV and film
in 1 year. And all of that is stemming from the fact that we have this wonderful tax credit that was put in place in 2008. And our organization with the Georgia Production Partnership, our main goal is to keep that in place. Mm-hmm. We're an organization of actors, writers, directors, producers, union folks, crew people, you name it, the top of the top in the industry. And our whole goal and our whole mission is to educate people about the importance of that tax incentive staying in place because of the economic impact that it does for the state of Georgia. We're lucky right now.
We are so, so blessed to have all of this coming in. Well, when you take a look at who benefits, because you hear people say, well, gosh, the traffic's bad, and my school buses can't move around the way they need to, and people really are not getting the full pluses. How do we deal with little things like traffic in comparison to, I heard in our last meeting, mm-hmm. $7.3 billion
with a B,
not an M, right. $1 billion
in economic impact for the state of Georgia.
That's tremendous. But yes. How do you, in the neighborhood, so to speak, mm-hmm. get to be involved and benefit as well?
There are so many ways because of the trickle-down effect for this. Mm-hmm. If you think about it, the crews come into town. They have to have hotel rooms. They have to buy food. The catering companies that come through here, the towns themselves get a little bit of publicity that's going on. Because when the production is gone, a lot of times those communities become a tourist attraction for people to come and see what's happening. I mean, take Fayette County, where I live. Mm-hmm. The Walking Dead is one of the number one shows here. And it has transformed that little town. It started as this little sleeper town, and now they have hotels that are being built. Mm-hmm. The studio, Pinewood Studios,
which is now absolutely phenomenal.
Marvel is out there, mm-hmm. and it's one of the reasons we're having this huge boom. $2 billion Hollywood spent last year in hard spending here in Georgia.
And you said, and that term clicks my ear immediately, hard spending. Mm-hmm. People are thinking that this is just a dot here and a dot here and a dot here. But throughout the state, we are benefiting in a multitude of ways.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's flip the script. You talked about the production side and mm-hmm. the producers, directors, and writers, but then there's the actor.
Yes.
And we really do benefit.
Absolutely. I mean, I know that me as an actor, I've been doing this for about 10 years now professionally. and the roles that have come in here. Now, I have to say that a lot of the bigger roles are still coming out of LA. We're mm-hmm. hoping to change that scenario.
Right.
We're working with a lot of different organizations here to help show people that we have some awesome actors here locally. And you are seeing several that are making their way up the chain.
Yes, you are.
I know I've seen several auditions happen my direction that I wouldn't have had before. And it's not just the commercial and the industrials, which is the bread and butter of a lot of actors here locally, but all these big film productions that are being shot here. When you come to one of our GPP meetings, you see our state film office person come up and read 4 pages
of different productions.
Yes.
It's exciting. Mm-hmm. There's the neighborhood person can benefit. The actor can benefit. Here's what I like. Mm-hmm. Recent, in the last few years, someone came up to us and said, "Hey, can we use your house for a music video?" Mm-hmm. How quickly did my husband say yes? It's like, oh, the industry is in my neighborhood.
Absolutely.
There's benefits to having a property that they want to come to mm-hmm. to shoot their music video, their film, their commercial, their whatever. We are just glad that they're here. But there's some strategic things that I want to talk about.
Okay.
That we as citizens of Georgia need to be aware of. And we need to be the ones really cheerleading to make sure that we hold on to the industry that is making Georgia boom. We'll be back in a moment. It's all about us, and we're making lots of money.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day, I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the ways I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
We've had some great folks. You know, there's so much talent in Atlanta, so much talent in Georgia, mm-hmm. and so much talent around the nation that are coming here. And what we found in building content is highlighting those folks who are just really delving into wanting to do some really great meaty pieces. And probably some of you recognize that face down in the bottom, Christina Lee Storm, who is the on the board of the Producers Guild, came into Atlanta and just really poured her heart into students and women, and that is, we have to focus on those folks who will pour into us as we highlight them and give them a platform within the Atlanta, Georgia area. So that's what was happening there.
Can I keep her? Okay.
People Store, PR director, former business manager, Atlanta Film Festival. Now that's the one I didn't know.
Oh, really?
Mm-mm. Yeah. I knew you, you know, helped with the film festival, but I didn't know what your, you know, position was.
Yeah, I started as a volunteer, a
I did that for 3 years, and then I got on staff for 3 years.
That's very cool.
Was business manager, and I helped with the membership for a year. And I loved working with them, but it's seasonal. It wasn't like a year-round.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
We're back with Patricia Taylor from Georgia Production Partnership, and we are just really excited about all the things that are going on in Georgia. Film is in the air. Television is going great. Everything is booming. Hotels are booming. Mm-hmm. All of the people that I know who are in the hospitality industry are grinning from ear to ear.
They really are.
Because they're making a truckload of money.
Well, I don't know if you realize this, but I used to work for Georgia Tourism.
Oh, my goodness.
Georgia Department of Economic Development. And it's one of the ways that I learned about the state of Georgia and what other locations we have throughout the entire state of Georgia. The good thing about Georgia that makes it above some of the other states with tax incentives is the fact that we have all this different kind of topography that's going on. You have everything from the mountains to the sea,
it's
to the
beautiful
antebellum homes, mm-hmm. to mm-hmm. the crops that are growing out here. The only thing Georgia doesn't have is a desert.
Really?
You can make
everything
it look,
else.
You can make it look like any type of city or town that you could even imagine.
Here's what I love. Mm-hmm. For us who live in the south end of Atlanta, mm-hmm. we're benefiting greatly because we have Pinewood.
Yes.
We have, as you mentioned earlier, The Walking Dead. Mm-hmm. Then we come right through up to 85 mm-hmm. south, and we have now the Atlanta Metro Studio.
Right.
So it's growing on the south end, it's growing on the north end, and everybody's getting that opportunity to feel a part of that boom. How do we keep it? Many states have lost.
They have.
And we've gained because of it.
We have gained because of it, and a lot of other states are looking towards Georgia as the template
yes.
on what to do. If you remember, North Carolina put a cap on their tax incentives.
Yes.
Louisiana was another one. Florida was being affected, and now they're feeling the repercussions, and a lot of that work has come here to Georgia because we offer a 30% tax break. It's 20% plus another bump up for 10% if you put the Georgia peach at the end of your production.
Wow.
So it's a total of 30%, and productions, money, that's what producers look for. That's what Hollywood looks for.
To stay within budget.
Yes, within budget. And these productions would not be coming into Georgia if it wasn't for that tax incentive that's going on. How do we keep it? We keep it by putting the infrastructure in place that we have. You had mentioned about the studios. There
yes.
are like 11 or 12, there may be even more from the last time I read, studios that are popping up. Studios like Pinewood that have come in, and these big mega hits that Marvel is putting on, Spider-Man they're
yes.
shooting. All of these are pumping money into our economy. Like I mentioned before, the trickle-down effect.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you have carpenters who are building sets. You have people who are actually going to these studios and being part of it. They have stunt companies.
Yes.
That
in
are
fact,
part of that.
We our stunt people have grown in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
I can think of immediately four different stunt people who weren't. They weren't working in Hollywood,
mm-hmm.
but they came back home to Georgia,
mm-hmm.
and now they're working, and the work is growing for them. Now, here's a bad note for me.
Oh, Lord.
All of Hollywood is moving
yes.
to Georgia.
Yes.
Okay, and as you mentioned earlier, we still have this thing, as actors are concerned, that they are pulling the biggest roles from the actors in L.A. They're just now beginning to say, wait a minute, they've got some
talent.
Really good talent
mm-hmm.
in Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
But what has happened is all of Hollywood is buying a house in Atlanta. Now, if I were a real estate agent, that would be okay. But since I'm not, I'm really looking at how do we kind of level the playing field in that regard. Everybody's moving here.
Mm-hmm.
Is it taking jobs away from the above line and below line teams? And is it taking jobs away from actors?
Well, let me answer that in two parts.
Mm-hmm.
First, I don't think it's taking away from the crew at all. In fact, our crew is busier than they have ever been before. And that's why you see like the Georgia Film Academy being put in place.
Which is booming.
Yes, because people want to get into this industry and we need to train more people. All the people that are working right now are working and working and working, and we need to get two or three deep. So we are
so
working,
that we never plateau.
Exactly. And we are working with the institutions here in Georgia, all the educational institutions, to be able to train that next level of crew. Mm-hmm. Now on the acting side, it is harder when you see all these LA actors coming in, yeah, and they have these wonderful resumes because they've been out there and they're working on LA Law or The Good Wife or whatever it is.
Whatever it is, right.
But that's why our local actors need to step it up.
And here is a point that makes it really important. Mm-hmm. I have noticed that organizations like GPP, mm-hmm, like Women in Film and Television Atlanta, there's so many organizations that are stepping up the game with offering seminars and workshops, yeah, and trainings. And as you mentioned, the Georgia Film Academy is training those who are on behind the camera. Mm-hmm. So we're getting more involved with becoming more excellent in our craft.
Absolutely.
So that we're looked at seriously for the larger roles. But then as I looked at the industry coming from LA to Atlanta, I realized that the big guys are coming into Atlanta and there's this amazing group of independent,
oh yeah,
filmmakers that are rising in Georgia.
And
all over Georgia.
The Atlanta Film Festival is a good example of that. They're like the keepers of the independent,
yes,
film around here. And GPP actually partners with the Atlanta Film Festival through our PA Academy.
Yes.
That goes on. People, mm-hmm, are wondering, well, how do I get into this industry? Well, a lot of people start out as a PA. And if you go through the PA Academy, we have a wonderful education person, Linda Burns.
Yes, she's great.
She is phenomenal. She knows this business, and she's tough on people. Mm-hmm. She weeds out the people who aren't going to stay, who aren't serious about this. But you go through this, and you see the director's track, you see the producer's track, and you make a decision on what direction you want to go in. And she brings in all these experts. And that's one of our goals with GPP, is the education side. We do workshops, just like you had mentioned, Women in Film and Television.
Yes.
I was on their board a few years ago, mm-hmm, with you two.
Yes, we were
both. I believe
both.
We were in,
we're
the,
in the same,
same
position. Yes, we were.
And it's an amazing group. It's a, it's Susan Moss is now the executive director of that, mm-hmm, and they are bringing in all kinds of workshops, and we're partnering with them. GPP likes to support other organizations too. We support all the film festivals that are in our local area here so that we can grow that independent scene that you were talking
and
about.
And I think that's what makes it work. Mm-hmm. This is good stuff. You know, there's so much for us to learn about this growing industry in Georgia. When we come back, we'll talk about the who's who and how you can get involved. Stay with us.
As an 18-year-old, I let my mistakes kind of take over my life. I was 0.5 credits away from completing high school, and I didn't do it. When I found out that I was pregnant, I know that I had to do something for myself if I wanted to make her a better person and provide a better life for her. My family never stopped pushing for me to be better because they knew what I could become and who I could become as a person. Surprise! My support team is amazing. The educational director here, my sister, and even my 7-year-old daughter has just been more than the support that I could ask for.
And to see you makes me proud.
I've been given an opportunity, and I'm just thankful for it.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
We'd do anything for kids. Yet 1 in 5 children in the U.S. struggle with hunger. Help end childhood hunger near you. Learn how at feedingamerica.org.
Us's clown. A selfie or us's.
That's funny.
That's cute.
Okay, I'm just going to turn to my camera.
Okay.
And let you do it.
Okay, cool.
I'll do that.
Okay, I'm going to let you do it.
Okay, sure.
We're back with our friend Patricia Taylor. You know, what I'm giggling about is Patricia and I have known each other a little while now, so we get to giggling about stuff off camera, but at any rate.
Yes.
At any rate. So we were talking about all the organizations you can get involved with. Mm-hmm. Here's what I want to say.
Okay.
There's no excuse for anyone to say that they can't get involved with filmmaking and television.
Absolutely.
In Georgia, because there's so many different things to do. There are costumers, stylist buyers, makeup artists, production assistants, their camera crew, their colorizers, is that how you say it?
Yes.
There's all the post-production that we really want to happen in Georgia.
We want to keep that here.
We
want to
keep it here.
Right. There's a movement on right now to be able to keep post, because a lot of it still goes back to California. And there are some amazing post houses here in Georgia that you can get the tax incentive for doing that.
So that, and here's another thing that people don't recognize. So you're an independent filmmaker, and your film is only up to $100,000. Okay, $200,000. But if three different filmmakers get together to become one strong group
and get up to $500,000, you can get the tax credit.
Correct. I love that.
And there's many different organizations that you can be a part of. You know, the film market here, the indie film market, is booming.
Yes.
And that's the other thing that we want to work on keeping here. We want to make our own productions.
Exactly.
You know, we see a lot of Hollywood coming in here, but the ultimate goal is to be able to produce them here.
Exactly.
Homegrown writers and directors, and be able to produce it locally. And some of the organizations you can get involved with to do that are the Atlanta Film Festival. They have screenwriters groups with that.
Mm-hmm.
Women in Film and Television Atlanta.
Which we were both a part of.
Absolutely. And GPP.
And GPP, which is awesome.
And then the film festivals you can get involved, the Bronze Lens
Film. Bronze Lens. There's Black Women in Film.
Mm-hmm.
There's
Rome, Macon.
Macon is getting a lot of buzz right now.
Savannah. Savannah Film Festival is amazing. The Atlanta Film Festival and the Atlanta Jewish Film Festival.
And isn't the Atlanta Jewish Film Festival the largest now?
In the world.
In the world. So if you thought that you couldn't, you definitely can.
You can get involved any way possible, and it's all about networking.
It is.
It's getting to know these people, getting to know the producers, the directors, the actors, and the cool thing about Atlanta that I love the most is we help each other out.
And that is why so many actors and producers, directors and production people are moving to Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
I hear it over and over again in the circles that my husband and I go through, is that Atlanta, Georgia, still has a hometown flair.
It does.
But big business attitude when it comes to film and when it comes to television.
We're serious. We're business people.
But we're still GGs.
We are still GGs.
Yeah, and we want to raise our children and our grandchildren, and we want to have great family lives, and we want to be able to have an opportunity to run through Piedmont Park and do those kinds of family things. And Georgia actually offers the highest mountains, the most beautiful lakes.
Yes.
And a lot of scenery, as you talked about before, that's just perfect to shoot. So it's a perfect place with a great tax incentive. And then we have each other as helping hands.
Exactly.
When you think of all the things that you've seen in your years within the industry as a professional within this, from film to television, what would you say is the one thing that has kept you yourself, Miss Patricia Taylor,
yes,
right here in Georgia versus running off to the LA scene?
Family's here. My two stepdaughters are here. My grandson is here. Affordable housing, wonderful agent that I have here. and a community that supports one another. I really love Atlanta. I love the state of Georgia.
Yes.
It's a wonderful area to live in, and it's affordable. You know, you go out to LA and a lot of places, people can't even afford to live.
Exactly.
But the quality of life here, the hospitality that people have. Mm-hmm. I'm a Southerner. I like living in the South, and I'm so excited that this industry is here, and we want to keep it going, and we want to keep it growing.
What can the average person who's not necessarily in the industry, they've got mm-hmm. a niece who's always wanted to be an actress,
sure.
or a grandson who said, I can be a cinematographer, mm-hmm. what can anyone do in order to keep this incredible industry right here in Georgia?
Learn all you can about the area that you want to be in. Mm-hmm. With GPP, we have student memberships that they're welcome to come in and interact with producers and directors and writers and actors, mentorships, so that you can learn about that. Go to workshops. If you're an actor, take acting classes.
Yes, indeed.
I mean, keep your tool going mm-hmm. there. One of the best workshops I had was with Mike Panuski, who books everything in the world, and work with working actors. I think that the state of Georgia has so much to offer people, and it's only going to continue to grow if people allow it to grow. And it's going to be throughout the whole state of Georgia that benefits from this, from people working, from people living here,
yes.
and growing the infrastructure here.
It's an extraordinarily exciting time mm-hmm. in Georgia.
It is.
All across Georgia, we're seeing growth. $7.3 billion.
An economic impact for the state
of
Georgia.
I just like saying billion, y'all. I do. I like saying billion. So if we don't get involved, we're missing something. And if we do get involved, what part of the pie is your $7.3 billion? Patricia, thank you so much for being with us.
This
has been a joy.
Thank you for having me. I love being on here with you.
Oh, this is good stuff. And if you didn't know, Georgia Production Partnership. Get involved. We call it GPP. Mm-hmm. We'll meet you next month. And every month, it's always happening. Same place, same station. I'm BJ Arnett. God bless. So I'm going to ask a question right now. How many of y'all are from L.A.? Raise your hand.
There you go.
Uh-huh. See there? See
there?
There
you go. All right? And see, those from L.A. now that have come here realize that there's a lot going on in Georgia.
It is.
That Georgia has a lot to offer. And those of you, again, that are in this room, take a look at each other. Get involved with what one another are doing, because it is happening. And we need you to even get involved. That's why I wanted to make sure that the $6 billion, that we take a time to breathe that in and not let it just slip out of our hands.
That's awesome. That's the truth. I'm going to hold my part. I don't know about y'all. Are we done?
We are done. And at this point, all that's left really is to say thank you.
Thank
for
you,
your time.
Guys.
We appreciate it.